من التزم السلفية حصل الخير كله وحصل أجرا عظيما وفيرا كبيرا لأنه لزم هدي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب. صلى الله وبارك الأشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، الحمد لله in our previous lesson we discussed arba masail, the four masail pertaining to what is upon every single Muslim to adhere to. And thus, after that, we go on to the next issue that the Shaykh discusses. It's the second Rishala, the second part of the Muqaddimah of the introduction. The Shaykh of Islam, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, he discusses, and he divides this into three issues. So he begins by saying, اَعْلَمْ رَحِمَكَ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ يَجِبُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ وَمُسْلِمَةٍ تَعَلَّمُ هَذِهِ ثَلَاثَ مَسَائِلِ وَأَمْرُ بِهِنَّ. So he says, know, may Allah have mercy upon you, that is upon every Muslim male and female to learn these three issues and act upon them. Al-Ula, أن الله خلقنا ورزقنا ولم يتركنا حملا بل أرسل إلينا رسولا فمن أطاعه دخل الجنة ومن عصاه دخل النار. ودليل قوله تعالى إنا أرسلنا إليكم رسولا شاهدا عليكم كما أرسلنا إلى فرعون رسولا فعصى فرعون الرسول فأخذناه أخذا وبيلا. And so, the Shaykh goes on to mention, in relation to this, so the first of these three, issues is to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. And he provides for us, he sustains us. And he doesn't leave us without any mere goals or purpose. Rather, he sent to us a messenger. And so whoever obeys him, enter Jannah. And whoever disobeys him will enter the fire. Whoever obeys him will enter Jannah, and whoever disobeys him will enter the fire. And the proof is the statement of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Naam, and the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, indeed, we have sent to you a messenger that bears witness upon you, just as we sent to Fir'aun a messenger. Thus Fir'aun disobeyed the messenger. So we seized him with a severe punishment. And so Shaykh Aḥmad, an-Najmī, rahimahullah, he mentions in relation to this in his commentary of this first principle, or this first issue, is the message al-ula. أن الله خلقنا ورزقنا ولم يتركنا حملا. So the first issue that Allah Ta'ala has created us, He sustains us, and He hasn't left us without a purpose. أي لا نؤمر ولا ننهى بل أرسل إلينا رسولا دعانا إلى التوحيد وحذرنا من العصيان ومخالفة وحذرنا قبل ذلك أن نشرك مع الله أحدا فقد مكث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم 10 سنوات لا يأمر أحدا بشيء غير التوحيد. And so the Shaykh, he goes on to explain what is meant by the fact that we weren't left without a purpose. Now, we weren't merely left without a purpose. Now, what we understand for this, by way of this, is that we were not, it's not the fact that we were left without being commanded, nor were we left without prohibitions. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to us a messenger that called us to Tawheed and warned us against disobedience and opposition. Right? Opposition to this affair of Tawheed and Avanana. And before all of that, He warned us against the affair of us associating anything in partnership with Allah. When the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he remained for 10 years, right, this was at the beginning of the Nubuwwah, of his da'wah, for a 10-year period in Mecca, where he did not command anyone of anything except of Tawheed. He didn't command of anything other than Tawheed. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the first 10 years of his da'wah, this is what the Shaykh is explaining, was laying the foundations. And no doubt the foundations are Tawheed. And Abi Umama, radiallahu anhu, قال عمر ابن عبسة السلمي رضي الله عنه كنت وأنا في الجاهلية أظن أن الناس على الضلالة وأنهم ليسوا على شيء وهم يعبدون أوثان فسمعت برجل بمكة يخبر أخبارا فقعدت على راحلتي فقدمت عليه فإذا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مستخفيا تراع علي وقومه فتلطفت حتى دخلت عليه بمكة فقلت له ما أنت قال أنا نبي وقلت وما نبي قال أرسلني الله فقلت وبأي شيء أرسلك قال أرسلني بصلة الأرحام وكسر الأوثان وأن يوحد الله ولا يشرك به شيئا. And so, this narration of Abi Umama, radiallahu anhu, where he mentions that Amr ibn Abbasa, and Sulami, radiallahu anhu, he mentions that myself, whilst I was in the state of Jahiliyyah, I would regard the people to be upon dalala, or regard the people to be upon misguidance. And that they were not upon something which was correct and significant. And these were the individuals that were worshipping the Othan, They're worshipping idols. Then I heard of a man in Mecca that were informing the individuals of a particular piece of news, or particular new pieces of news. So I mounted my riding beast and headed towards this man who was in Mecca. And thus, he was the messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was in a state of hiding, however he was apparent amongst the people with him, these people. And so, I entered upon him in Mecca. And I just said to him, and what are you? He said, an-Nabiyyun. I am a prophet. So I said, what is a prophet? He said, arsalni Allah. That Allah has sent me. And so I asked him, and what has he sent you with? And then the reply from the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was arsalni Allah bi silat al-arham wa kasr al-awthan. وَأَنْ يُوَحِّدُ اللَّهِ وَلَا يُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْءٍ. That Allah sent me with the affair of Silata Arham. So keeping of the family ties and breaking of the idols. And that Allah is singled out and nothing is worshipped along with him. And so he mentions this, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so after this hadith, Shaykh Aḥmad, an-Najmī rahimahullah, he goes on to mention, وَعَلَى هَذَا فَيَّجِبُ أَنَّ أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَمْ يَخْلُقَنَا وَيَرْزُقَنَا لِغَيْرِ حُكْمَةٍ وَلِغَيْرِ غَايَةٍ مَنْشُودَةٍ وَمَطْلُوبَةٍ. If إن العاقل من المخلوقين يتنزح أن يعمل عملا لغير حكمة منشودة في ذلك العمل فكيف بجبار السماوات والأرض. And so the Shaykh mentions in commentary after this hadith, so thus it's upon us to know that Allah Ta'ala created us, but Allah Ta'ala did not create us, nor did he sustain us, without some wisdom within it. Or he did not do these things without a purpose or a goal. For indeed, if you have an individual that is aqil, an individual that is of sound mind and intellect from the creation, they would never regard that a person does an action, any action, without any purpose or any wisdom within it. So what about with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, jabbar samawati wal ard? If we accept that ourselves as creation, we are deficient in many ways, we will not perform an action without a purpose, then how could this be said of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is free from all forms of deficiency? Now, and Shaykh goes on to mention, إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَلَقَ هَذَا الْقَوْنَ سَمَاءَهُ وَأَرْضَهُ وَجِبَالَهُ وَبِحَارَهُ وَمَعْ فِيهِ مِنَ الشَّمْسِ وَالْقَمَرِ وَاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَخَلَقَ الْعَوَالِمَ الثَّلَاثَةِ كُلُّ ذَلِكَ خَلَقَهُ لِحِكْمَةٍ أَرَادَهَا فَجَعَلَ الْمَلَائِكَ عَالِمًا كُلُّهُ خَيْرٌ يأمرهم بما أراد من السياسة هذا بسياسة هذا القوم. So Allah Ta'ala created this creation with its heavens, its sky, and its earth, and its mountain, and its seas, and that which is contained within it, from a sun and a moon, a night and a day. And he created the three abodes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created all of these things for a hikmah, for specific wisdom and reason that he wanted and required from the creation itself. And so he made the malaika, created the malaika, a creation and a world where all of them upon good. And he commanded them with everything that he wanted them to perform, all the actions that he wanted them to perform. And thus, this is what they did. And this is what is known from these from this creation. وَقَدْ جَعَلَ لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ فِي هَذَا الْقَوْمِ مَلَائِكَةً مَلَائِكَةً لِلْبَحَارِ مَلَائِكَةً لِلْرِيحِ وَخِزْنُهَا وَإِرْسَالُهَا وَمَلَائِكَةً لِلسَّحَابِ وَمَلَائِكَةً لِلْجَنَّةِ وَمَلَائِكَةً لِلنَّارِ وَمَلَائِكَةً لِلْأَرْحَامِ وَمَلَائِكَةً ملائكة الموت إلى غير ذلك. And so Allah Ta'ala has created the malaika, and he's created the malaika with various goals or with various jobs and actions that he required from them, or that he sought for them to be upon. And so, you have the malaika for the seas, and the malaika for the wind, are those that would hoard and hold the wind, whilst those that were put in charge of sending the wind. Likewise, there's malaika for the clouds, and angels for Jannah, and angels for the Nar. Likewise, you have malaika in relation to the wounds, and you have malaika for death, and other than that. وَجَعْلَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ مُؤَحَّلَيْنِ لِلْخَيْرِ وَالشَّرِّ. And so, as for the jinn and the ins, then they were individuals that were upon either خير, good, or شر, evil. So it's possible they could be of one or the other. Or ta'a wa masiya. And it's possible they could be upon obedience or disobedience. Imtalahum bidhalik hikmatan minhu subhanahu wa ta'ala khalaqahum lil'ibadah. And so he tested them with this. And this is a hikmah from him, a wisdom from him. And he created them for his worship. وصلت عليهم الشياطين. And the shayateen were put upon them. وَزَيْنَ لَهُمَ الدُّنْيَا. And the dunya was beautified for them. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَطَاءَهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَصَاهُ. And so from them, from the jinn, and from the mankind were individuals that were obedient. I obeyed Allah. And from them were those who disobeyed. نعم وطاعة لا تكون طاعة إلا إذا كانت خالصة خالصة لله وتابعة لما بينه الله في كتابه وعلمه الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أمته. So الطاعة, action of طاعة, so the action of obedience cannot be considered of that except if it's sincerely for Allah. And it follows that which Allah Ta'ala has clarified within His book, and that which was taught by the Messenger, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to His Ummah. فالأمم التي مضت كل أمة لها رسول أرسل إليها وختم الرسول بمحمد وختم الرسل بمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله الله إلى هذه الأمة يدعوهم إلى عبادة الله وحده ويحذرهم من عبادة غيره. فمن أطاع هذا الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم فاز بخير الدنيا والآخرة ومن أصاه لقي العذاب الأليم. And so the Umam, the nations which have passed and have come forth, each of these nations had a messenger that was sent to them, and the seal of all of them was Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him to this ummah to call them to the worship of Allah alone and warn them against the worship of other than him. So whoever obeys the messenger, then he will attain success of the good which is within the dunya and the akhirah. And whoever disobeys him, then they will meet, a painful punishment. ما هو السبب في إهلاك الأمم التي حلقت أليس عصيانهم لرسلهم. And so when we ponder upon the reason for the destruction of previous nations, no doubt it's due to their disobedience. It's due to their disobedience of their messengers. Or do we say it's due to the disobedience of the messengers? And do we say, Bala, no doubt it is. Or isyanahum li rusuli. It's their disobedience to the messengers. فما أهلك الله قوم نوح إلا بسبب أسيانهم رسولهم نوح عليه السلام وما أهلك الله قوم عاد إلا بذلك وذلك قوم ثمود. So Allah تبارك وتعالى did not destroy the people of نوح عليه السلام, nor did he destroy it. No, he did not destroy the people of Nuh alayhi salam, except due to their disobedience to Nuh. Likewise, he did not destroy the people of Ad, except for the same reason. And likewise, Thamud, the Qawm Salih, And other than them, from the umam, from the nations, Fir'aun wa qawmuhu, those of the other nations as well that came before, Fir'aun and his people, the people who Shu'aib was sent to, Madian, the Qawm al-Lut, and how many nations previously were destroyed, and we just do not know of them. And Allah Ta'ala has not informed us of them. Indeed, Allah has not informed us except of a small number of the messengers. إذا علمنا أن سبب حلاك الأمم هو عصيانهم لرسلهم. So then, we know, and we've been taught, that the reason for the destruction of the nations is their disobedience to their messengers. فإن الواجب علينا أن نطيع رسولنا ونطيع رسولنا فيما أمرنا به من عبادة الله وحده. And so, what is the wajib, what is the obligation upon us, is that we obey our messenger in that which is commanded us with, in relation to the worship of Allah alone. ولنعلم علم اليقين أن الله ما خلقنا ورزقنا إلا لنعبدوه وحده لا شريك له فمن عبد غيره فقد أتى بذنب الذي لا يغفر أو بذنب الذي لا يغفر واستوجب الخلوف في النار وتحريم الجنة عليه. So we know with certain knowledge that Allah did not create us nor provide for us, except that we worship Him alone without any partners. And so whoever worships other than Him, then indeed he's come with a grave sin, which is not forgiven, and an action which requires a khulul fi nar. The individual being within, or necessitates individual being within the hellfire for eternity. And the Jannah being haram for them. And Allah Ta'ala mentions, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُكْفِرُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَكْفِرُ عَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَكْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكْ لِمَنْ يَشَاءَ وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ افْتَرَى إِثْمًا عَظِيمًا. Indeed, Allah does not forgive that the one associates partnership with Him. Or He forgives that which is lesser than it from that which He wills. And whoever associates anything in partnership with Allah, then indeed they've invented a lie, which is a grave sin. وقال على لسان عيسى عليه السلام يا بني إسرائيل اعبدوا الله ربي ربي وربكم إنه من يشرك بالله فقد حرم الله عليه الجنة ومأواه النار وما للظالمين من أنصار. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى has mentioned the statement of Isa عليه السلام. O بني إسرائيل, worship Allah, my Lord and your Lord. For indeed the one that associates anything in partnership with Allah, then indeed Allah has made the Jannah haram for him, and his abode will be the hellfire. And there will be no one that can come to aid the wrongdoers. And so this is just an explanation and some commentary from Shaykh Aḥmad an-Najmī in relation to the first mas'ala, the first issue that is discussed in this second muqaddimah, the second introduction. And we'll conclude with this bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. And bi'idhnillah, in our next sitting, we will go on to discuss the second issue. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. Wa barakallahu fikum. Wa sallallahu wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.